Good morning. So in this video, I am going to discuss about NEET 2021 So Chemistry questions. Part 2. In the previous video, we had a discussion about the NEET questions up to question number 74. The remaining questions will be discussed in this video. Right. Now, I'll look at question number 75. So this is a question. Choose the correct option for graphical representation of Boyle's law, which shows a graph of pressure versus volume of a gas at different temperatures. So here you are given four graphs in which pressure and volumes are plotted against each other at different temperatures. Okay, so which of the following graph is a correct representation for Boyle's law? So actually the correct answer is option four is the correct answer, because you know that pressure and temperatures are directly related with each other according to Gay-Lussac's law, isn't it? Now this option 4 graph shows that at high temperature the pressure also high and vice versa, isn't it? So that the correct answer for this question is option 4. Okay, right. So now question number 76. The question is, the structure of beryllium chloride in solid state and vapor phase are. So what is the structure of beryllium chloride in solid phase as well as in vapor phase? So the correct answer is option 1, whereas beryllium chloride has a chain-like structure when it is in solid state and it has a dimeric structure in vapor phase. So the correct answer is chain and dimeric structures respectively. Okay, so I have given the structure of beryllium chloride in two different phases, whereas in solid phase the BeCl2 is having this kind of structure. So it's nothing but the chain like structure of beryllium chloride. Okay, whereas in vapor phase, you know that two times the beryllium chloride molecule will be together as a dimer. What do you call it as? Dimer. So in vapor phase it has dimeric structure. Okay, in solid phase it has chain like structure, and in vapor phase it has dimeric structure. So that's how option 1 is the correct answer. Solid phase chain structure, vapor phase dimeric structure. Okay, right. So now question number 77. Right, question number 77. Which one of the following method can be used to obtain highly pure metal which is in liquid state at room temperature? The only liquid metal at room temperature is nothing but mercury. So mercury is the only substance which is a metal which exists in liquid state at room temperature, isn't it? And it has low boiling points. Boiling point of mercury is low. And we use a method called as distillation method. We use distillation method for refining of mercury. Okay, so because you know you very well that the metals which are having low boiling point are refined by distillation method. Low melting point are refined by liquevation method, isn't it? So according to that different methods, mercury being a metal with low boiling point can be purified, refined by distillation technique. So the correct answer is option 3. Okay, right. Next question number 78. Question number 78. So which of the following compound will show metamerism? So you are given compounds, formula compounds. So among this, which one will show metamerism? So first of all, you should know what is mean by metamerism. Okay, so metamerism is a kind of isomerism, so exhibited by organic compounds. Organic compounds which are having same molecular formula, same function group, but different alkyl groups are bonded with the function group is generally called as metamerism. Organic compound with molecular formula, same function group, same, but the nature of alkyl groups bonded with the function group will be different. Generally, ethers and ketones exhibit metamerism. So I have given some example for that. Okay, so now look at the ether compounds. Both are nothing but ethers with formula C4H10O, isn't it? Right, now so both are having same molecular formula. Molecular formula of these two compounds are C4H10O, but look at the function group, same ether function group, but look at the alkyl groups which are attached with function group. So in the first compound, the left side we have methyl group, whereas right side we have n-propyl, isn't it? Look at the next one. The ether group is bonded with ethyl on left hand side and ethyl on right hand side. But now when you compare these two compounds, you can see that function group is bonded with different alkyl groups, isn't it? So this is what we call it as metamerism. Okay, so that, so this ether compound has metamerism. Ether with at least four carbon only can have metamerism. And I have given another example also, a ketone, pentanone. So this is keto group, isn't it? Both are having C5H10O formula. First compound la methyl group left side, right side propyl group. Second compound la on either side ethyl group, isn't it? Up now when you compare these two, you can see that keto groups, functional groups are attached with different alkyl groups, isn't it? So this pair also example for metamerism. But according to the options given, the compound which shows metamerism has molecular formula. The first one is the right. Okay, so that is ether compound is given as one of the option. Ether with C4H10O formula can have metamerism. Okay, whereas in ether compounds, to exhibit metamerism, the compounds should have at least four carbon atoms. Four and above compounds only, carbon number with four and above only shows metamerism. Okay, right. Then question number 79, the correct option for number of body center unit cells in all 14 types of Bravais lattice unit cells. Okay, so totally there are 14 Bravais lattice unit cells are available. Among that 14 Bravais lattice, how many unit cells are having body center atom? How many are having body center atom? The correct answer is option 4. Option 4 is the correct answer. Because among the four Bravais lattice unit cells, cubic unit cell, tetragonal unit cell and orthorhombic, only these three are having body center atom. Because I have given the diagram also. This is nothing but cubic unit cell, which has a body center atom. The other one, tetragonal with body center atom. The last one is orthorhombic. So only these three Bravais lattice unit cells are having body centered atom. Okay, answer is option 4. The number of unit cells which are having body centered atom is about 3. Okay, right. Now let us go for question number 80. Right, so which one of the following polymer is prepared by addition polymerization? So among the four polymers, which one can be prepared by addition polymerization? Okay, so the answer is option 1, Teflon. What is it? Teflon. So addition polymerization is a kind of polymerization in which the monomer molecules are simply added with each other without elimination of any simple molecules. Whereas Teflon is prepared by addition polymerization technique, because during preparation of Teflon polymer, the monomer is simply added with each other, so nothing is getting eliminated. Okay, right. So that is how the option 1, Teflon, is the correct answer. Teflon is nothing but polytetrafluoroethylene. Actually, Teflon chemical name is polytetrafluoroethylene, which is prepared by polymerization of tetrafluoroethylene. So this is tetrafluoroethylene, CF2 double bond, CF2, CS2 double bond, CS2 ethylene. When hydrogens are replaced by fluorine, tetrafluoroethylene, isn't it? When n number of this tetrafluoroethylene monomer polymerizes, giving the polymer polytetrafluoroethylene, PTFE, which is commercially called as Teflon. Okay, you can see here nothing is eliminated, isn't it? Whereas in other three options, nylon 66, novolac, dacron, so these are the polymers which are formed by condensation technique. So here, during formation of these polymers, some simple molecules such as water is removed off. Okay, so the answer, addition polymer, is Teflon. Correct. Now question number 81, a particular station of All India Radio, New Delhi, broadcasts on a frequency of 1368 kilohertz. The wavelength of electromagnetic radiation emitted by the transmitter is, and you are given a hint, speed of light is about 3×10⁸ meter per second. Okay, right. So now what is given is, you are given the frequency of a radiation. Frequency is about 1368 kilohertz. Using that, they are asking what will be the wavelength of the radiation which is emitted from that. Okay, right. So this can be solved this way. So this is the data what is given, the question. Frequency 1368 kilohertz. First let us make it as hertz, so × 10⁻³. So I have converted into kilohertz, I have converted into hertz per second, isn't it? Okay, right. Then this is another data which is given in the question itself. Velocity of light 3×10⁸ meter per second. Okay, Now what you are going to find out, you have to find out wavelength of the radiation which is emitted from the transmitter, isn't it? So now this is the formula you have to use. Nu is equal to C by lambda, isn't it? You want lambda, after rearrangement you are getting C divided by nu, isn't it? C value is given 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second divided by the frequency also given 1368 into 10 power 3 hertz per second, isn't it? Right, so after simplification, when this goes up 10 power minus 3, isn't it? Plus 8 minus 3, 10 power 5. Then 3 divided by 1368. That gives 0.002193 into 10 to the power 5. So when you make it as a whole number, if you multiply by 10 power 5, so a 5 decimal, isn't it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 219.3 meter, okay? So that the wavelength of the radiation which is emitted from that transmitter is about 219.3 meter, okay? So option 1 is the correct answer. Option 1 is the correct answer. Okay, right. So now question number 83. Question number 82. Right. So there you are given some reactions. Which one of the following reaction is an example for metal displacement reaction? Okay. So among the following reactions, one belongs to metal displacement reaction. So you have to choose the right option. Okay. Right. The correct option is option 2, reaction between chromic oxide and aluminium, giving on heating, giving aluminium oxide and chromium. Okay, right. Now when chromic oxide reacts with aluminium, here what is happening is this aluminium metal comes and displaces chromium, isn't it? So that it forms aluminium oxide. A metal is getting displaced by another metal, isn't it? So that it is a metal displacement reaction. So option 2 is the right answer. Then look at other options. First one, thermal dissociation of KClO3, isn't it? It is an example for decomposition type of reaction. First option is example for decomposition type. Then third option, Fe plus 2HCl, giving FeCl2 plus H2, isn't it? Right, now here what is happening is ion is coming and displacing hydrogen, isn't it? So it is a non-metal displacement reaction. A metal is displacing a non-metal. A metal ion is displacing a non-metal hydrogen. So third option, example for non-metal displacement reaction. Last one is similar to first option. So lead nitrate thermal dissociation. But last one also, example for decomposition reaction. So according to the question, metal displacement reaction is option 2, reaction between chromic oxide and aluminium. Okay, right. Now question number 83. So which is an incorrect statement among the following? Actinide contraction is greater than lanthanide contraction. There is a correct statement. There is a correct statement. So you have to find out incorrect statement. So just remember, this is a correct statement only. Okay. Because you know, in actinides we have 4F electron. 4F electrons are having poor shielding effect compared with, actinides we have 5F electron. 5F electrons are having poor shielding than 4F electron, which are present in lanthanides, isn't it? So therefore, actinide contraction is greater compared with lanthanide contraction. That's the correct statement only. Then second option, most of the trivalent lanthanide ions are colorless. But this is the correct answer actually, because trivalent lanthanides are colored when they are in solid state. So it's given as colorless, but most of the trivalent lanthanides ions are colored. So that the incorrect statement is option 2. Okay, lanthanides are good conductors of heat and electricity. Option 3 also correct, because you know lanthanides are metals, so generally metals are good conductors of heat and electricity, isn't it? Actinides are highly reactive metals, especially when they are in finely divided form. So comparatively, actinides are more reactive than lanthanides. So that among these four, incorrect statement is option 2 only. Okay, right. So incorrect statement, most of the trivalent lanthanide ions are colorless. It is incorrect because they are colored actually. They are colored, right. Now question number 84. The dihedral angle of least stable conformer of ethane. So options are 120 degree, 180, 60 degree. The last one is 0 degree. Okay, right. Now actually ethane is found to be in three different forms. There is three different conformers. Staggered form, skew form, eclipse form. The order of stability between these three forms. Staggered form is more stable. than skew form, which in turn more stable than eclipsed form. Because see, in staggered form, the repulsive force between the atom is very less. Repulsive force is very less, so stability is more because the dihedral angle is about 60 degree. Whereas skew formula, the dihedral angle is between 0 to 60 degree, less than 60 degree, so that it experiences more repulsion. It has less stability compared with staggered form. So eclipse form, the dihedral angle between the bonds is the minimum, it is about 0, so that eclipse form experiences more repulsion between the atoms, so that the eclipse form is the least stable form of ethane conformer. Okay, so that the question is dihedral angle of least stable conformer. Least stable conformer is nothing but eclipse form. Its angle is about 0 degree. Dihedral angle in case of eclipse form is 0 degree. Okay, right. Because you know eclipse form, that CH bonds are lying in the same line. They are lying in same line. That's why the bond, dihedral angle between the CH bonds is about 0. Okay, right. The next one, question number 85. So it's a match type of question. You are given some molecules with their structures, geometry. So you have to match it. Okay, right. So PCl5, phosphorus pentachloride. Phosphorus pentachloride has trigonal bipyramidal structure. Okay, right. So next, SF6, sulfur, hexafluoride. It has octahedral shape. So AB6 type of molecules, it has octahedral shape. BrF5, it has square pyramidal shape. BF3, boron trifluoride, AB3 type, it possesses trigonal planar structure. Okay, so that A answer is 4, A4, B3, A4, B3, C1, D2. So that the option 1 is the right one. Option 1 is the correct answer. Okay, right. So very simple, just matching the molecule with their geometry. Okay, so now question number 86, you are given a reaction CH3CH2COONA. It's nothing but sodium propionate, a sodium salt of carboxylic acid with 3 carbon atoms, which is called as sodium propionate. Okay, right. When it reacts with a mixture of sodium hydroxide and another substance, giving ethane with sodium carbonate. So now what is the other substance which is used along with sodium hydroxide? Okay, so it's nothing but calcium oxide actually. So option 3 is the right answer. Actually, this reaction is called as decarboxylation. What is it? This reaction is nothing but what? Decarboxylation, removal of CO2 group. For removing CO2 group from an organic compound, we are supposed to use a substance what is called as soda lime mixture. Actually it is a mixture what you call as soda lime, which is a mixture of sodium hydroxide and calcium oxide. Up here, the missing substance for this decarboxylation reaction along with sodium hydroxide is nothing but calcium oxide. Okay, right. So option 3 is the right answer. Okay, right. Next question number 87. The intermediate compound X is formed in the following reaction. So what is the structure of X? What is the structure of X? Okay, so here the reaction, you are given a compound benzene with CH3, which is nothing but toluene. It is undergoing oxidation with chromyl chloride. CrO2Cl2 is nothing but chromyl chloride in presence of a solvent, carbon disulfide. It gives an intermediate X, whereas that intermediate on acid hydrolysis giving an aldehyde compound. Benzene with CHO, what you called as benzaldehyde. Okay, right. So actually it is a named reaction, what you called as ETAR reaction. What is it? ETAR reaction. So this is what the exact reaction. Okay, toluene reacts with oxidizing agent CrO2Cl2. As a result of that, it gives this intermediate. Okay, benzene ring CHOCrOHCl2 about twice. This compound on hydrolysis in presence of acid catalyst giving benzaldehyde. Up now the compound X, intermediate X is this one. Okay, so look at the options. Option 1 is the correct answer. Okay, right. Question number 88 match, you are given some reactions, you have to match with the properties given. Okay, so first one, formation of sulfur trioxide from sulfur dioxide and oxygen, isn't it? Actually this reaction is occurring in a tropospheric troposphere. So it is, this reaction is responsible for pollution of troposphere. Okay, so that first one, A answer is option 4. A answer is 4th. Then HOCl in presence of sunlight dissociates to form OH free radical and Cl free radical, isn't it? So correct. So now this reaction is responsible for ozone depletion. Okay, so B, 3rd. Calcium carbonate reacts with sulfuric acid. So this reaction occurs due to acid rain. Okay, so what do you call it as stone leprosy, isn't it? Right. The last one, nitrogen dioxide dissociates to form nitric oxide and oxygen. So this reaction is responsible for formation of photochemical smog. Okay, so the last one, NO2, giving NO and O, is answer is smog. So that A 4, B 3, C 1, D 2. So option 3 is the correct answer. Okay. Right, question number 89. Now we go for question number 89. That also a match type of question. Okay, right. So you are given some reactions, some name reactions. You have to match the name reactions. Benzene with CO and HCl in presence of AlCl3 and CuCl. Okay, so actually it's a name reaction. What do you call as Gaterman reaction? A, answer is 2. Then second, B, RCOCS3. Your compound with COCS3 group with NaOX. It's nothing but haloform reaction. Okay. Then C, alcohol with carboxylic acid. Alcohol with carboxylic acid, which is nothing but esterification. C, 4 answer. Okay. D, a carboxylic acid with halogenation. Halogenation of carboxylic acid, which is nothing but HVZ reaction. What you call it as Hell-Wohlhaut-Zelensky reaction. So A, A2, B3, A2, B3, C4, D1. Okay, so option 4 is the right answer. Okay, question number 90 also match type question. Question number 90 also a match type. You are given some complex compounds with their magnetic moment values. So you have to match them. Okay, first one, Fe CN63 minus. So here Fe is in 3 plus oxidation state, which has D5 configuration. And the Licon, nature of Licon, CN minus cyanide Licon is a strong field Licon. So that it may cause pairing of that 5 electrons. So it can be paired in this way. Now, FeCN63- complex, the number of unpaired electron is about 1. So that its magnetic moment is 1.73 Bohr magneton. Okay. So that A answer is option A, 4. Okay, right. Second, FeH2O 6 times 3 plus. In second, B complex also, Fe is in 3 plus state, so D5 configuration. But the nature of Licon, H2O Licon is a weak field Licon which cannot pair up the electron, so that D5 configuration is half filled with 5 unpaired electrons. All the electrons are unpaired, 5 unpaired electrons, so that magnetic moment value is about 5.92. But second one, first one is the answer for second complex. Third complex, FeCN6 4 minus. Third complex, Fe is in 2 plus oxidation state. Okay, so 2 plus D6 configuration, Licon strong field, but D6, when it is gets paired, there will be no unpaired electron at all. Okay, so that the magnetic moment will be 0 for FeCN6 4 minus. The last complex of 0, so you can match this way, isn't it? C with second. D. In D also, Fe is in 2 plus state, D6 configuration, but the Licon is weak field, so that it cannot pair up. So that the D6 configuration can have this one, isn't it? So here you can see there are 4 unpaired electrons, so magnetic moment value about 4.90. So D complex can match with third one. Okay, right. So now the answers are A with 4, B with 1, C with 2. D is matching with 3. So option 4 is the correct answer. Okay, right. Now question number 91. So there you are given a reaction, tribromoaniline. The compound is tribromoaniline, which on reaction with sodium nitrite and HCl at a temperature about 0 to 5 degrees Celsius, around 0 degrees Celsius, isn't it? It is forming a diazonium compound. The diazonium compound on reaction with the reagent R is giving tribromobenzene. This is nothing but what? Tribromobenzene. But now here, so the first step is nothing but diazotization. First step is diazotization. Second step is reduction reaction. The diazonium chloride salt is getting reduced into a tribromobenzene compound, isn't it? Right now, for the second step reduction, what is the reason to use? That's what the question. Actually, reduction, so that we use the reducing agent ethanol. Probably ethanol will be used for this purpose, because ethanol can be easily oxidized, you know. So it can act as a reducing agent. It reduces this benzene diazonium chloride compound into tribromobenzene compound. So answer is option 2. Right, next question number 92. Question number 92. There you are given a reaction. So what is the product formed in the following reaction? Okay, right. Right here, the reagent used for this reaction is sodium borohydride in presence of ethanol solvent, isn't it? Okay, so basically it is nothing but reduction reaction. But here there is a possibility of reduction of this ester group as well as keto group. But sodium borohydride being a mild reducing agent, so it reduces only the keto group. So according to the preference order between ester group and keto group is getting reduced in preference than ester group. Now this group is getting reduced up, so that H will be added over here. Up now it becomes single bond benzene ring with single bond OH. Benzene ring with single bond OH. The ester group is not at all disturbed. Ester group not at all disturbed. So the answer is option 4 is the right answer. So after reduction of keto group, this portion will become CH single bond OH. Okay, right. Here you have to remember there is a possibility for reduction of ester group as well as keto group, but in the order compared with ester group, keto group is reduced in presence of sodium borohydride. Okay, right. So next question number 93. From the following pair, which one is not an isoelectronic pair? So among the four pairs, one is not isoelectronic. In the sense, one is not having same number of electrons, you have to identify. Okay, the first option O2 minus F minus having 10 electrons, Na plus Mg2 plus 10 electrons, Mn2 plus Fe3 plus, both are having equal number, 23 electrons. So option 4 is the right one. Fe2 plus and Mn2 plus are not isoelectronic because they have different number of electrons. Fe2 plus is having 24 electrons and Mn2 plus is having 23 electrons. So that last option 4 is the correct answer. Okay, that pair is not belongs to isoelectronic, which is not isoelectronic. Okay, that's the question. Right now, question number 94, a question which is based on electrochemistry. Okay, so molar conductivity of 0.007 molar acetic acid. So this is nothing but concentration. The molar conductivity 20 Siemens centimeter square per mole. So molar conductivity is given. Now the question is, what is dissociation constant? What is dissociation constant? They're asking Ka. Okay, right. So now this data is given in the question. Concentration, molar conductivity at this concentration is 20 Siemens centimeter square per mole. Okay, right. Now you are given a hint that molar conductivity at infinite dilution of H plus and acetate ions, isn't it? H plus, it is about 350, and for acetate ion it is about 50 Siemens centimeter square per mole, wasn't it? But now using this you can find out the molar conductivity at infinite dilution of acetic acid. Okay, so mere just you have to add these two values, so you will get about 400, isn't it? Right. But now using lambda c and lambda not infinity, you are able to find out alpha value, because you are going to calculate Ka. So this is the formula for calculating Ka, c alpha square divided by 1 minus alpha, isn't it? C is given in the question itself, 0.007 molarity. You need alpha, isn't it? So alpha can be calculated using this relation. Degree of dissociation is molar conductivity at a particular concentration divided by molar conductivity of the same substance at infinite dilution. Okay, so now when you substitute 20 divided by 400, so you are getting alpha value about 0.05. okay, now you can substitute in Ka formula. So alpha value is very small, so that the alpha value in the denominator can be neglected, so that you can have only the numerator. So therefore the formula Ka equal to C alpha square. Okay, this is the value of C, alpha value 0.05 the whole square. Okay, so finally I'm getting 00000175, isn't it? So when you write it as a single decimal according to the option given, 1 2 3 4 5, isn't it? Up 1.75 into 10⁻⁵ mole per liter. So that is the answer, 1.75 dissociation constant of this weak electrolyte, acetic acid, is 1.75 into 10⁻⁵ mole per liter. Okay, so option 3 is the correct answer. Okay, right. So next question number 95. Okay, right. So look at the question. Choose the correct option for the total pressure of a mixer having 4 gram of oxygen, 2 gram of hydrogen, with total volume about 1 liter and temperature about 0 degree Celsius. Okay, R value is given, 0.082 liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole. Okay, right. Now they are asking to find out total pressure. Total pressure. So P total you are supposed to find out. Right. So what are the data given? You are given R value. R value is this one. Temperature 0 degree Celsius, Kelvin 273, volume 1 liter. Okay. And as well as mass of oxygen and hydrogen in the mixture is given. Okay. 4 gram oxygen mass, 2 gram hydrogen mass. Now using this, you have to find out number of moles of oxygen and hydrogen. Divide it by their molar mass. Number of moles of oxygen, 4 by 32, the molecular mass of oxygen, isn't it? Number of moles of oxygen is 4 by 32. Number of moles of hydrogen, mass of hydrogen 2 gram divided by molar mass 2 gram. Okay, right. Now this is the formula, P total equal to N total into RT divided by V, which is similar to PV equal to NRT formula. Okay, N total. So I have calculated N total here. Okay, N total, sum of the number of moles of oxygen and hydrogen. Okay, NO2 plus NH2 is nothing but N total. 4 by 32, 2 by 2. So after this, finally you are getting N total 1.125 moles. Okay, but N total value 1.125. R value is given in the question, temperature also, volume. So when you simplify, you are getting an answer 25.18. So option 3 is the right answer. Okay, right. Now question number 96. The correct option for the vapor pressure of a solution at 45 degree Celsius with benzene to octane, which is having molar ratio 3:2, is, okay. So they are asking the value of vapor pressure of a solution. Vapor pressure of solution. They are asking the solution which contains two substances. One is mercury, another one is octane. Okay, right. You are given, in the hint, you are given the vapor pressures of benzene and octane. Vapor pressure of benzene is 280 millimeter mercury. Vapor pressure of octane on the, it is about 420 millimeter mercury. Okay, so P naught value of mercury and octanes are given. Okay, right. And as well as you are given the molar ratio. Molar ratio between benzene and octane is about 3:2. Okay, right. But now the, what you have to find out? The total vapor pressure of solution. So this is the formula, P total equal to P naught A into XA plus P naught B into XC. So vapor pressure of the first component into its mole fraction plus vapor pressure of the next component into its mole fraction. Okay, right. Let us have XA, A substance mercury, and B is octane. Okay, right. But now P naught value, P naught of A is 280 divided by the mole fraction of mercury, 3/5. So molar ratio 3:2, but total number of moles, we can have it as 3+2, 5. Number of moles of mercury 3, number of moles of octane 2. But therefore mole fraction of mercury 3/5 plus the vapor pressure of octane is 420 into mole fraction of octane, number of moles of octane 2 divided by total number of moles. Okay, right. When you simplify this, you are getting an answer 360 millimeter mercury, 336 millimeter of mercury. Okay, so look at option 3 is the correct answer, 336 millimeter mercury. Okay, I think you can easily follow this problem. Okay, right. Now question number 97. For an irreversible expansion of ideal gas, under isothermal condition, which of the following is the correct one? Okay, so it is an irreversible expansion. under isothermal condition. So isothermal process. Isothermal process in the sense the temperature remains constant. Temperature remains constant. So in a isothermal process, there will be no change in internal energy of the system. Isothermal process, because of constant temperature, there will be no change in internal energy of the system. Therefore, delta U will be equal to zero. Delta U is equal to zero. Then, in a isothermal irreversible expansion, the change in entropy, total change in entropy, will be greater than zero. Greater than zero, which means it is not equal to zero. Okay, so that the condition for irreversible expansion of ideal gas under isothermal condition is delta U 0 equal to 0, delta S total not equal to 0. Okay, right. So option, look at option 3, delta U is equal to 0, delta S total greater than 0, which means it is not equal to 0. Okay, right. Next, question number 98. Question number 98. Among the following molecule, which one is non-polar? Which one is non-polar? The answer is stibium pentachloride. Stibium pentachloride, SbCl5, isn't it? So whereas SbCl5 is having a geometry of trigonal bipyramidal, so this is what the geometry of SbCl5, isn't it? So trigonal plane, and one chlorine above the plane, another chlorine below the plane, they are perpendicular to each other, isn't it? So they are pulling the electron pair towards itself. These two chlorines are just opposite to each other, isn't it? Similarly, the other three chlorines, which are lying on the trigonal plane, occupies the corner of trigonal shape, and you know that the bond angle between them is about 120 degrees, isn't it? They are in different direction, as well as they are pulling the electron pair towards itself, so that this molecule can behave as a non-polar. This molecule is behaving as non-polar. So the correct answer, option 3, SbCl5. Okay, right. So next, question number 99. Question number 99, which is not strictly correct. So among the four, one is not strictly correct one, that you have to find out. Okay, so look at the option 1. Increasing acidic strength. Increasing acidic strength among the hydrogen halide, when you go from fluorine to iodine, acidic strength increases. So that is a correct order only. It is a strictly a correct order, because going down the group, the size of the halogen atom increases, so that it is difficult to hold the atoms together, as well as the stability of bond becomes weaker when we go from fluorine, hydrogen fluoride, to hydrogen iodide. So that among the hydrogen halides, hydrogen iodide is having weak bond between hydrogen and halogen, so that can be easily broken. So HI can easily release H plus ion. So that going down the group, generally the acidic character of hydrogen halide increases. Okay, so that's the correct one. Actually, answer is option 2 is the correct answer. There you are given increasing pKa values. So H2O has lesser pKa, and going down the group, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, the pKa value increases. It is given that pKa value increases, but this is not strictly a correct one, is a incorrect one, because the electronegativity in the oxygen group decreases. Generally, electronegativity in a group decreases, down the group decreases. If oxygen is the most electronegative, then gradually it decreases down the group, isn't it? Right. Okay. Now, the acidic character order, H2O is least acidic. Down the group, acidic character increases. So that tellurium compound is most acidic. Tellurium compound is most acidic. Oxygen compound is oxygen hydride. Water is least acidic. The one which has most acidic nature can have higher Ka value. If a substance has greater Ka value, then it can have more acidic character. If the Ka value is greater, pKa value should be lesser, because pKa is nothing but minus log of Ka. So that Ka and pKa are inversely related. So tellurium compound most acidic, higher pKa value, higher Ka value, lower pKa value. So that, and when you compare that with water, water is least acidic, lesser Ka, higher pKa. So when you go from H2O to H2TE, the pKa value is supposed to decrease. Now here, this one is given as increasing pKa values, but actually The pKa value is supposed to decrease from H2O to H2 to tellurium. That is why option 2 is the incorrect among these 4. Okay, the other two also right option. Ammonia less acidic, acidic character, increasing acidic character. Going down the group, the acidic character decreases between NaS3, PS3, ASH3 and SbH3. Then oxidizing power of carbon group, carbon dioxide, silicon dioxide, that also increases down the group. Okay, so that option 2 is the incorrect one. Okay, so it's given increasing pKa, but actually here the pKa value decreases from H2O to H2 to H2TE. Okay, right. The last question, question number 100. The slope of Arrhenius equation, ln K versus 1 by T of a first order reaction. You are given the value of slope value in a graph ln K versus 1 by T. Slope value is about minus 5 into 10 power 3 Kelvin. Okay, right. What is the value of EA? So they are asking what is the value of EA. Okay, right. So in Arrhenius equation, the slope value will be equal to minus EA by R. This is the formula. Slope value is equal to minus EA by R. You should know R value also. Okay. So R value is given in the question itself. 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. Okay. Now you can substitute in the formula. Formula, if you rearrange it, you will get EA is equal to minus slope into R, isn't it? Right. So now I have substituted value. Slope value is this much. Then R value is this one. Okay. Right. Therefore, EA is equal to, so just you have to multiply this. Minus minus sign you can cancel. Therefore, EA is equal to the product of these two values. That is a product of slope and R value. This is slope value. After cancelling the negative sign, R value, product of these two is equal to 41.575 into 10 power 3. So 10 power 3 as such, product of 5 into 8.314 is this much, isn't it? Right. So if you multiply by, so yeah, actually here you are getting EA value with a unit joules per mole, isn't it? Because you are given slope value with a unit Kelvin. R value has unit joule per Kelvin per mole. Kelvin per Kelvin gets cancelled. Our final unit left out is joule per mole. So that answer is 41.575 into 10 power 3 joule per mole. But whereas in the options, you are given all the options in kilojoules. If you want to make it as kilojoules, you have to divide by 1000, isn't it? So you may have only that 41.575. Okay, so look at the options. Look at option 1, 41.5 kilojoules per mole. Okay, that is the correct answer. Okay, right. So I hope you are able to follow the solutions what I have discussed for NEET 2021 chemistry questions, right? So keep watching my other videos also. Thank you very much.